And I'm Amelia Counts.
And we are back with CNN 8
with 7th grade. We will now move on to our next segment, weather,
with Ryder and Nathan.
What a combo.
Hello, I am Nathan with the weather. I have weather for the rest of this week and the weekend. Nate, on Friday, we have a 60% chance of precipitation, 84% chance of humidity, 84% humidity, and the wind will be in the 15 miles per hour, and the weather will be at the high of 34 degrees Fahrenheit at 2 degrees Celsius. Saturday will be 36 degrees Fahrenheit, 2 degrees Celsius, 20% precipitation, 78% humidity, and wind of 12 miles per hour. Last Sunday, we had 20% precipitation, 75% humidity, and the wind will be at 10 miles per hour, the high of 35 degrees Fahrenheit and 2 degrees Celsius.
I'll take it from here, Nathan. Anyways, I hope you guys enjoy your 3-day weekend, and who knows, maybe it'll snow or something and you can go sledding. Have a great time.
And that was your weather for today.
Now, a word from our sponsors.
Goldfish.
Mommy, I'm hungry.
Here you go, sweetheart.
Yay! Goldfish!
I remember when I would eat goldfish as a kid.
Do you want any goldfish, sweetheart?
Yes, please.
Yay! Goldfish!
Goldfish, growing with you through the generations.
The snack that smiles back, goldfish!
Hey guys, welcome back to Cooking with the Boys.
As you may have noticed, we have lost our hats. Our sponsorship has been canceled.
But anyway, we're going to cheer ourselves up by cooking some ramen. So let's get started!
First, you have to add water to the pot. You add 2 cups per package. We have 3 packages, so we will add 6 cups.
Now, you will have to bring the water to a boil before you can put the ramen in the pot.
Then we checked the temperature and it was hot enough to start cooking the ramen.
Make sure to take the seasoning packets out of the package before you put the ramen in the pot.
Then you can put the ramen in the pot and let it cook for 3 minutes.
Make sure to break apart the big clumps and continuously stir while the ramen is cooking.
Now, when the 3 minutes is up, take it off the burner and place it on a hot pad.
Then take the seasoning packets and sprinkle them on top of the ramen.
Okay. Now stir thoroughly for about a minute to make sure it is all mixed in good.
Now your ramen is done and you are ready to dish it out.
Of the day. What movie will you watch on your 3-day weekend? 3.5 to be exact.
My favorite movie is The Croods 2.
Grey's Anatomy.
What's your favorite movie, Nala?
Croods.
Croods? Okay.
My favorite movie is My Little Mermaid.
The Goldbergs.
My name is Lydia, and my favorite movie is The Lord of the Rings, Return of the King.
The new Croods movie?
Hello, I'm Caleb Balkin, and I'm in 6th grade. My favorite movie is Grown Ups.
Hi, I'm Violet Counts, and my favorite movie is Lion King.
What's your name?
Chandler.
And what's your favorite movie?
Disney.
What movie are you going to watch over your 3-day weekend?
I'm going to watch Polly Pockets.
Polly Pockets? Okay.
Can you guess who this teacher is?
Their favorite vacation place is Disney World. They were born in Illinois. Their favorite drink is raspberry white chocolate latte.
They have no pet, but is a handler for a dog. Their favorite subject to teach is Bible study.
Their favorite restaurant is Los Cabos, and too many others to name. They have been teaching for over 20 years. If they had all the money in the world, they would take trips, give money to church, charities, and families and friends. When they were younger, they wanted to be a film director.
Can you guess who this teacher is? It's Deaconess Kelly Hart.
Birthdays brought to you by Dad Jokes.
Why was 2019 afraid of 2020? Because 2021. Of all the inventions in the last 100 years, the dry erase board has to be the most remarkable.
Now, for birthdays of the week, we have Isabel Boehner and Ella Grassi, both in fifth grade, on January the 17th.
Owen Bruni in kindergarten on January 13th.
Anna Schuberg in fifth grade and Avery Van Wielden in fourth grade, both on January the 11th.
Lastly, Mrs. Wunderlich has a birthday on January 15th.
Happy birthday, everybody!
Birthdays brought to you by Dad Jokes.
Did you hear the rumor about the butter? Well, I'm not going to spread it. Why couldn't the bicycle stand up by itself? Because it was too tired.
Now we're going to take a look at 8th grade string art projects that took forever.
Hello and welcome. For today's arts and crafts segment, we will be looking at 8th grade's math project, string art. String art is a technique that uses geometry to create wonderful and interesting designs. These designs may be recognizable objects or abstract images. They were graded on 3 different points: design, string art, and overall. And these are some examples of the string art that they did.
Thanks for watching this week's upload
of CNN 8 with 7th grade. Hope you liked today's upload.
Don't forget to like and subscribe.
Bye, Crusaders!